Check out thechosenprime.com in the link in the description below for this and other great items.
All right, welcome everyone to another Radio Free Cybertron review. I'm your host, Diecast, and today we have Titans Return, Legends Class, Gnaw, which is very, very nice. Take a look at the packaging. Yeah, a little picture of Gnaw in his Sharktacon mode. You have on the back Robot and Sharktacon, Hasbro. This is ages 8 plus, whole bunch of stuff made in Vietnam. And Generations on the top here. And let's go ahead and get this guy out of package. So here is Gnaw out of package in his robot mode. And we'll just do a quick look at him. His head does rotate from side to side. There is no ball joint, so no up and down. But due to transformation, you do have a little bit of up and down. You have this that kind of sticks in front of his face. Just a little bit. That's about as far down as it'll go. So, not too bad. I will say, when you get him out of package, his arms are kind of popped out, so all you have to do is pop them in, and then also his feet are kind of like this, so all you have to do is flip the feet around, which gives him a heel, and then the arms are kind of your choice, the little front arms, how you want to put them. I just have them down as kind of like a heel spur, and his mace, take a quick look at that, is holy on one side, or actually on both sides, so it's meant to be that way, or at least they evened it out on both sides. And then the other thing on this is, as you can see in this packaging, his tail is between his legs, just like that. But what you can do, so we'll fling this around, and then there's that nice cavity right back there, that big hole. And you can kind of flip that up to fill in that hole if you want. It's an option. That's what I would do. Not that you're going to be looking at it from behind, but I know some people are very picky about their back toys, about how their toys look on the back. And here you have, on the back, you do have a little Tomy indentation, Hasbro SA. So I guess South Asia, maybe? And B-2976B. So, there's that. Let's go ahead and just do a size comparison before we move on. So there is Gnaw. And here is Wheelie. So you can see Gnaw is definitely a very, very short character. See if I can get him. No, his knees do not go any further than that. So that is as far as he can stand up straight. That's it. That's all you're getting. So let's zoom in on there just to get a real good look. Again, very short, a lot shorter than I kind of expected, but I still kind of love him, so let's go ahead, we'll get Wheelie out of the way, and let's go ahead and remove his mace, and we'll get into the transformation. So to transform Gnaw, first thing you want to do is spin his head around, it's just like that, come to the back, flip the tail out, it just gives you some clearance to put his head in. This piece right here, which is part of his lower jaw, can come up a little bit, probably right to there. And then the feet, you flip the face back around, and then you're just going to fold the legs up, just like that. And there's going to be a tab on the inside of the legs that tab together, and then a tab. These clear green pieces, they're using clear pieces for tabs. Oh, great. Tab that all together. And there's two tabs right here on the bottom of his heels. And it just basically balls up. And that forms the top half of him. Then the legs, you just want to unclip that. Or the arms that are becoming legs, you just unclip them. Make sure they pop into place on the back. This was really hard the first time to actually pop into place. I almost thought I was going to break it, but then all of a sudden they just snapped in. So it was actually easier that time than it was. Then you can just rotate the arms around and they will become the feet. And then flip the tail up however you want it. You can have it like that or like that. I think that's the proper way. And then there you have just these arms. These arms are on just a little rotation. There's no ball joint or anything. And then you still can get a little up and down motion from his head. And the bottom you can open a little bit wider, but that's as far up as it'll go. So you can have a big bite where you can get it down about that far. You kind of have to frog leg this guy, because if you have him straight up, he's front heavy. So if you just frog leg him just a little bit, that'll give you more a little bit more room to work. And there you have Gnaw. And again, you know, not a lot of paint, but not bad for a Legends class figure. You get some purple in there. You get the clear green eyes, some gray over here, pink and blue little bottom teeth or something. But the blue on mine, there is some pink showing through there, so not too bad. And then you got the blue arms, blue feet, gray. There's a little bit of pink on here. He cleans up pretty nice for as, you know, holy as he is on the back in robot mode. In Sharktacon mode, he actually cleans up pretty nice. He is very small, though. You can see I could probably fit him in the palm of my hands. Let's just get an idea. Let's see if I have... Here's one of the Headmaster vehicles, those $4, $5 specials. And not much bigger than that. So here is Titan's Return Hardhead with him, and just for another size comparison. So for the weapon storage, they show it in the instructions in a really bad part. Basically, before you start flipping all this around and pegging this in. But all you have to do is come to the back here, and you can just slide it in. At the very end, I don't know why they show it in the middle of the instructions. Kind of really dumb. But that's all you have to do to slide in his weapon for the storage to make his tail. Why the instructions were the way they were, I don't know. They've been doing some really weird things in the instructions lately. So there you have it. He does have weapon storage, which makes sense because it becomes his tail. So, again, I just want to troop build the heck out of these guys, because these guys are very nice. And I did not find these in the store. I got these through a Chinese site, so that's how I was able to get Gnaw and get so many of them. I got them for friends. Melvar and Chris from the show, from RFC, are getting some of these, so I got three for myself, but I have an extra four coming, so I might just have seven of these guys. I'm not sure yet. I do really like them, and with the way they tab together, you can have, you know, one of these guys start splitting apart in half, just like in the movie, which I kind of like. I almost wish the teeth flip down so you can have like broken teeth or something. I know that's a lot to ask for a Legends figure, but I mean, for the price point, I really like that you can troop build these guys. If these guys were Deluxe or a Voyager, it would have been a lot harder to troop build. And they just, it's kind of, I don't know, there's just a really nice feeling about this Legends figure. It's almost like there's a cuteness to it that you just can't explain. I do want to throw something out there. It's been going through my mind a lot lately with some of the comments in the YouTube videos that there are some people that say, oh, you know, I don't like your review. Well, I met a lot of the reviewers. I've met Vangelis. I've met Pinaw. I hope I'm saying that right. I apologize if I'm not. We'll just say Ben for short. I've met Pack for Life. I've met Bobby Skullface, who I also consider a friend. So there's all these reviewers that are doing these. I've met Optibotomus, and I know a lot of people don't like Optibotomus. I personally, when I met him, he was a great guy. I had a good time hanging out with him for, you know, the hour that we hung out. But I met most of these reviewers, and I'm not saying don't watch them. As a matter of fact, go watch them. You know, see as many of these videos as you can. It helps everyone out, and it gives you a better understanding of the figure, because there's something I might miss, something they might miss. I mean, that's just the way these things work. So, again, I don't want to be the only reviewer that you watch. I encourage you to go out and watch other reviews. I just hope that I'm one of the reviews you watch. Again, thanks for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Just a quick add-in on the end of this, speaking of things I forgot, it comes with a collector's card. So you have a nice artwork piece of Gnaw. You have the Decepticon logo down here, Hasbro on this side, and you get some tech specs. So strength, he's a 7, speed, he's a 4. I believe that is brain power is a 3, and firepower is a 5, which I'm surprised they would give him a 5 for that, because he doesn't really fire anything. He's just, they're just better in numbers. So as an individual figure, he's probably a 1 or a 2, but their power is in numbers and not firepower. And there you go. So there's your tech spec card. Hopefully I didn't forget anything else, and we'll see you next time.